Le microbiote, c'est un
microbiota
avec lequel nous
is the bacterial world that we live together and we also evolve alongside. This is a new notion. It's been known for quite some time, but it has come to the forefront of medical work for a few years now. Microbiota are all the germs with which we live, or the whole microbial world with which we live. I'm going to try and talk about this microbiota, its origin, its development, its composition, the connection between biodiversity and the allergic risk, which is an essential element in this world. And finally, microbiota that doesn't really work well, dysbiosis. Normally, microbiota looks like this. Here we have DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid rotating onto itself. This is the DNA we have in our body. We have approximately 2 billion pairs of bases of deoxyribonucleic acid. This is our body, our skin, our eyes, our heart, our gut. At the top right-hand side and at the bottom, we see the DNA corresponding to the various microbial cells, which do not infect us, but rather coexist with us, live with us in our, on our skin, on our oral cavity, in our guts, in the vagina for ladies, in many different cavities in our body. And man, so like all living beings, evolves alongside. This is called the microbiome, metagenome, and these are components of our genome. Man, who normally shouldn't be able to do so, can digest an apple, although normally it doesn't have the necessary tools in the guts or the stomach to digest an apple. Now, the phylogenetic tree is not doesn't look like a normal tree for the microbiota. It looks more like a palm tree. The life arborescence is very special. Changes in human ecology affect the composition. Here we have a list of elements that are at the origin of the change. Water quality,
la fréquence des césariennes,
increase in caesarean sections,
des antibiotiques,
increased use of preterm antibiotics or antibiotics given to babies, reduced breastfeeding, the fact that families are of smaller size, that antibiotics are used in a widespread fashion, increased bathing, showering, use of antibacterial soaps, and also the use of mercury amalgams in tooth filling. This changes the composition of our microbiota in our gut, in our oral cavity. I mean, I have only listed some. There are many different human activities that are responsible for the changes in the microbiota. Here we have the two dominating species, Bacteroides and Firmicutes. And the difference can be seen in cat, pig, man in a very comparable way. The bacterial composition within the guts of large animals, including man and dogs,
is
initially dependent on the bacteria drawn from the soil, but apparently bacteria are selected by man because we don't have the minimum 53 genera of bacteria existing in the soil. We only contain 2 or 3 genera, which corresponds to a Darwinian selection. We select only those bacteria that are useful for us. The microbiome will depend very much on the location in the body, and the major factor for variation is proximity of the location with the external environment. In the woman's vagina or in the oral cavity, composition is very different versus the gut, which underlines one of the main elements, the relationship between the microbiota and the external environment. There are statistical connections and even physiopathological connections between some diseases and the microbial composition in our gut. Dysbiosis. Gut microbiota is one of the determining elements for obesity and type 2 diabetes. This composition is very special. Why? We don't understand.
Un très beau travail fait par
beautiful paper written by Mrs. Le Châtelier from INRA. She showed that in obese people, subjects, the brown curve versus the blue one, the dark one, or green one, there is a decrease in the composition of bacterial genes in the digestive tract. Apparently, obese people have less bacterial genes in their guts than non-obese people. There are other works in progress in order to confirm this assumption. Regarding autoimmune diseases and allergic diseases, let me remind you that these are complex diseases which require a very special genetic situation. We're looking at a lack of immune reaction, which can be simplified as follows. This is the hygienist assumption, which is has now come back to the forefront in its microbiotic version. Here we have the gut wall in a dotted line, inside a little round colored spots and outside triangles, and bacteria normally are at the origin of a number of characteristics in the immune system. And when there is a lack of bacteria, the immune system element, the little triangles, are idle. They have nothing to do because there are no bacteria. And therefore, they look elsewhere. They go towards the outside. And because of this, the immune elements may turn against us because they have nothing else to do. And this will lead to an autoimmune reaction. I mean, this is oversimplified, of course, but it is the microbiotic version of the hygienist hypothesis.